Hey there, this is a cool science project on how to make a potato battery. The principle behind this project is that when two different metal electrodes are immersed into an acid, it generates a flow of electron. In this case, we'll be using two different metals, that is copper and zinc, which will be immersed into potato. This contains different types of acids, and then this will generate a flow of electricity, and then we'll be using that electricity to glow an LED. So the ingredients, the prerequisites that we'll be requiring for this project are four potatoes. Then we'll require galvanized zinc nail, LED bulb, preferably in red color, copper wire, which has been isolated from an earthing wire. This is the earthing wire that I've used to isolate the wire, used for earthing. You'll also be requiring a multimeter, which is used to measure the voltage, a digital multimeter, but it's optional. But if you have it, then it's good. If you don't have it, it's okay. You'll also need a couple of jumper cables so that you can have a tight connection with the terminals. So we'll begin the project. The first step is to isolate the copper wire. This can be done easily, like this. You'll need four of them, or you can have an extra as well. A copper penny can also do. First, we just have a bench testing with a single potato, as in how much voltage does it generate, so that we can figure out how many potatoes we'll be needing to make a decent glow out of the LED lamp. The second step is to drill the screw into the potato and then insert a copper wire inside the potato at a different place. So these are the two different electrodes immersed into an acid. Let's check out the voltage. It's around minus 0.082. 0.080. So did you notice the minus sign? It means that we have connected the leads the opposite side. So now let's see. It's plus 0.80. So this means that copper is the positive terminal and zinc is the negative terminal. Before we proceed, we have to know a little bit about LED as well. The LED lamp is basically runs on DC type of voltage. So it has two terminals, that is positive and negative terminal. This has to be connected into a specific arrangement, that is the cathode and the anode has to be connected to the cathode and the anode of the battery as well. To identify the different terminals, this is the diagram of an LED. You will notice a groove onto the circumference of a LED bulb. A terminal that emerges from a groove is your negative terminal, that is cathode, and the other one is the anode. Generally, the length of a negative terminal is less than that of positive terminal, so it is an easy identification. So let's just have a bench testing whether it works or not. Now we have connected the two terminals to their respective, the negative to the negative and the positive to the positive terminal, and let's see whether it glows or not. Is there any glow? No, there isn't any. The problem is that the output, the voltage output out of the potato is too less for an LED bulb to glow. So what we'll do is we'll four or five such potatoes into series so that the voltage multiplies and it can get a decent glow of LED lamp. Step number three, find your copper wire to the zinc nail like this. And do this for three or four such times. And then just insert into the one end of the potato. Just drill it like this. Do this for all three potatoes. This is first, second, and this is the third one. The next step is to insert the copper wire of potato number 1 to the second. So just drill a small hole and then insert it into potato number 2. And do this for the third. The copper wire of second potato goes into the third, and the third one goes into the fourth. So we have connected it in series. Last but not the least, insert the copper wire into the first potato so that this gives you a positive terminal. You can see the zinc over there, zinc nail, on the fourth potato, that is your negative terminal. a little bit of science over here. So we all know that electrons flow from negative to positive terminals. So the fourth potato, which generates electricity, as we have inserted the copper wire into the third potato, the current adds up and then goes to the second potato. Then the current adds up even more, and then to the first potato, and then it goes to the positive terminal, which is your copper wire of the first potato. Now we'll make a small U so that we can create a definite positive terminal, which will attach the jumper cable to both the terminals, and then we'll connect it to the multimeter. So now let's check out the voltage. It's 2.74 volt, and I think that will be enough to power a LED lamp. I just did a pinch testing with the 2.74 volt, and I figured out that I'll need one more potato so that the glow is more visible, and I've cut the fourth potato into two pieces so that makes up two different potatoes. Now let's check out the voltage of these five potatoes connected in series. You see, this is around 3.63 volts, and that would be enough to power LED bulb. This is the LED bulb that we saw earlier. We know the positive and the negative terminals, and we'll connect it with the positive and negative terminals of the battery itself, the potato battery. So we'll connect the two terminals using jumper cables so that the voltage won't fluctuate. Now let's just zoom in to see whether there is any glow or not. Yes, you can see that it is glowing. And just focus on it. It is glowing. We'll just make some darkness so that the glow is visible. You can see it is glowing. If I remove it, it will stop glowing, and when I just touch the terminals, it will start glowing again. And if I remove it, if I connect it, remove it, connect it, you can see the glow. And this is how you make a potato battery, and hope you like this science project, and do subscribe. Thank you.